Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new here, hi, my name is Valentina. I'm a makeup lover and I like to test makeup products, and in today's video I'm going to test a new blush. And I have this new blush from Dior, this Dior Rosy Glow in Cherry. I've used this blush on my eyes, face and on my lips today, and I'll create this makeup look by using some of my favorite makeup products. So if you like what you see and want to find out more, then keep on watching. I already have my eyebrows on, and on my eyebrows I've used this Skinny Definer Brow Artist by L'Oreal Paris with this Fluff Up Brow Wax by Benefit. I've been loving to use this to on my eyebrows. This Brow Artist by L'Oreal Paris is really good. And I also like the color. I like it now because I have more of my natural hair color. So I've been loving to use these two on my eyebrows. They are really good. For my primer today, I want to use these two. I want to use this one on one side of my face and this one on the other side of my face. This is Dior Forever Velvet Veil. It's a matte primer. And this is Estée Lauder Double Wear Flawless Hydrating Primer. This is a matte primer and this is a hydrating primer. I like these two primers, but I feel like I want to apply them side by side to see which one I like more and which one is the best for my acne textured skin. So I'm going to apply this Dior Forever Velvet Veil on this side of my face and this Estée Lauder Double Wear Flawless Hydrating Primer on this side of my face. I want to see by the end of the day which one I like more between these two. And I'll update you about which one of these primers I like more in my next video. Next, I'll move on to my foundation. And for my foundation today, I'm going to use this Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundation. This is the new and reformulated Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundation, and I've used this one for the first time in my last video. So if you want to see a first impression video and also a wear test about this new foundation, I highly recommend you to check my last video. As a little update since my last video, I have to say that I still like this foundation. It has a really nice natural finish and is long lasting, so I want to use it again in today's video. And I get the best finish if I apply it with my beauty blender. This foundation has medium buildable coverage and a little goes a long way. You can have a super natural finish by applying a very thin layer everywhere, or you can layer it as much as you want to get medium to full coverage. Next, I'll move on to my concealer, and for my concealer today, I'm going to use this Natasha Denona High Glam Concealer. This is really nice and is my favorite right now. I like the finish of it and my under eyes look amazing all day with this concealer on. I also use this concealer as my eyeshadow base. Okay, look at how pretty is the finish. And I will set everything in place with my favorite setting powder at the moment, this Givenchy Prisme Libre powder in color 1. These four colors mixed together look very pretty and are very brightening on someone with very fair skin. And I like to apply this powder with a powder puff. I get a flawless airbrush finish if I apply it with a powder puff. Okay, look at this side with the powder on. I have to use powder every time I do my makeup because my skin gets oily throughout the day, and if I use powder, this helps a little. I usually apply my bronzer after my powder, but I'm going to apply my blush next because for today I have a new blush to test. So in today's video I'm going to test one of the new blushes from Dior. And I have this Dior Rosy Glow in the shade Cherry. Dior came out with 4 new colors for their Dior Rosy Glow blushes. And I bought this in the shade Cherry. This is how the packaging look for this new blush. And this is how this blush in color Cherry look. I don't have anything in my collection in this color, so I'm very excited to try it. This blush was made in France, has 4.4 grams and has 12 months shelf life. I already have the Dior Backstage Rosy Glow in pink. I've used this blush in color pink so many times on my channel, so I'm not going to use it today. The packaging is the same. This in pink and this in cherry. I'm going to swatch this blush on my hand first. I want to see how is the texture and how is the finish. And this is the pink blush and this is Cherry. This is more pigmented. I am very excited to try this blush. So let's move on and use it on my cheeks. Okay, this is very pigmented and a little goes a long way, so you have to be very careful with this one. I feel like this color will be very pretty for summer. It's gorgeous. I'm very curious to see how this blush will look on my eyes, so I want to apply it all over my eyelids. Okay, very pretty on the eyes too. I feel like I could apply mascara and this will be a look. I've used like a lot right now, but I'll go over with my beauty blender to blend out the edges after my bronzer. So next I'm going to apply my bronzer. And for my bronzer today, I'm going to use this one from Dior. This is Dior Forever Natural Bronze in the shade 4. I love this bronzer, it's really nice, it's not emphasizing my texture, my pores, my acne, and I love the color, so I also want to use it today. And now I like to go over with my beauty blender with whatever's left from my foundation to blend out the edges. And next I'm going to apply my highlighter and I'm going to use this one from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Hollywood Glow Glide Face Architect Highlighter in Moonlit Glow. I also want to use this all over my eyelids and on my inner corners. And for my eyeshadow palette, I'm going to use this one from What's Up Beauty. This is the Geode's eyeshadow palette. And I'm going to use this color from here called Rock on my lower lash line and in my crease. Next, I'm going to use this Earth-like on my lower lash line. I just love this color, it's gorgeous. And next, I'm going to use this color as eyeliner. This is called Terra. I also want to use a little bit of this on my lower lash line. This is Crystal. And I'll use my concealer brush to clean my under eyes. I'm going to apply my mascara and something on my lips, and I'll do this off camera and I'll be right back. And this is the finished makeup look. For my mascara, I've used this Dior Show Iconic Over Curl Mascara. I love this mascara so much, and I also mentioned in my last video that this is the best mascara from Dior. So if you want to try a mascara from Dior, I highly recommend you to try this Dior Show Iconic Over Curl, because my lashes will look and will stay the same all day, and I don't have to worry about my mascara when I use this one, so I highly recommend you to try it. And on my lips, I've used this Makeup Forever Artist Color Pencil in color Endless Cacao to line my lips. And all over my lips, I've used this blush from Dior. So I've used this blush on my eyes, on my face, and on my lips today. And I have to say that I really like this blush. I like this color a lot. And it's also very pigmented. Has a very subtle sheen to it. So the finish is very pretty. I like that it's not emphasizing my pores, my texture. And you can build this as much as you want without any problems. You can use this on your eyes, on your face, and also on the lips. So for now, I really like this blush, but I'll use it again and test it, and I'll update you about everything in my next video. I'll also update you in my next video about which one of these primers I like more, because I'm going to test this today. I would love to know from you guys if you like the finished makeup look, and please let me know what other makeup products would you like me to test next. But that's everything for today. I hope this video helpful, and I hope you like it. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and also ring the bell to be notified when I upload. I post every week, so make sure to hit the notification bell. I hope you'll have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!